Hello, and welcome to Making Your Therapist Proud. I'm Danny, and today I'm sketching on paper and lining and coloring in Procreate. I didn't have any really solid ideas when I started sketching this. I just knew that I wanted to draw big sneakers. I don't usually draw from the legs up. I'm more of a floating heads kind of guy. But I think the pose I ended up with is very pleasing and simple. Another thing I knew I wanted to draw was hoodies. Both subjects I draw in this video have hoodies, actually. I just think they're fun to draw. There's a lot of personality you can get out of a hoodie, with the hood and the drawstrings, and whether or not the sleeves are pushed up, and how baggy it is. It's just pleasing. It's also something I can draw without reference, which probably has more to do with it than anything else. Now I'm adding final details to the sketch, trying to find ways to fit more personality into the character. I could have looked up chunky sneakers for reference, and honestly I should have, but the generic shoes have an aesthetic of their own too. I'm not trying to blow anyone's minds with this illustration. It's more for practice and getting reacquainted with Procreate. And speaking of Procreate, here we go! As soon as I get the iPad centered. That shot would have been so clean if I simply knew what I was doing. Anyway, I'm carefully lowering the opacity of the sketch on the iPad to make absolutely certain that it shows up on camera. And once I've done that, I'm off to the races. I only use about 3 brushes in Procreate typically, and this brush is the one I use for detail work, but I was really feeling thin lines today, especially with bold shadows. It was a little bit of a challenge working on the face. I wanted to get this punk to look just greasy and haggard enough for their vibes to be just right. In the end, I think I did a pretty good job, especially once I fixed the tuft of hair on the left that just sucked. Oh, there! I'm drawing it right now! Ugh, look at it, look at that shape! It's terrible, it's no good at all, it's terrible in my eyes. I do really like what I do with the hair poking out of the beanie at the top, though. I think the flyaway tuft looks really cute. You don't know it yet because it's in a different video that is yet to be released, but I have been drawing so many beanies lately, and I always draw them the exact same way. I don't know if you noticed, by the way, but I'm using my nice mic. I figured out how to get the sound nice and crisp, which is funny because in the video which is not out yet that I have referenced twice now in rapid succession, I go on a very long tangent about how hard it is to work on audio. It wasn't hard. I was just lazy. Here I am drawing the greasy waves they have around their shoulders. I just really like drawing hair. I think it's fun. Especially if it's wavy hair. You know, this video is feeling a little sluggish. We still have a whole other illustration to get to. Let's speed this baby up! Ah, that's better. I've been watching a lot of art YouTube, more than I used to previously, just for research. That is my cat eating out of his food bowl.
He's hungry.
What was I saying? Right! I've been watching lots of art YouTube. I want to find my own style of video making, but it's good to pay attention to what's successful and finding what I personally really enjoy. There's this YouTuber named Kludwig that I really like, who speaks a lot about her day and what she's drinking, and speaks really candidly about the filming and editing process, and I really like watching her videos. She doesn't narrate through the entirety of her videos, which I'm sure makes them easier to put out. What I mean to say is, I love her stuff and you should go watch her. She sort of inspired me to go on my own tangents. Another inspiration I have is Mariah Elizabeth, who I believe is the reigning queen of art YouTube. Her stuff is really snappy and quirky, and I think I'd contribute her work to the reason I threw my hat into the YouTube ring at all. I'm nearly done with the lines here, just adding a few details to the shoes. I like how I drew the shoelaces nice and angular, definitely a Daniel calling card. I decided not to add the mesh panels to the leggings that shows their leg hair, because I didn't think it would come across correctly in the final illustration if you didn't own a pair of leggings like that of your own. Instead, I did some stylish stripes down the leg, which feels nice and dynamic. Onto the coloring, where I must admit I chose everything from one of Procreate's default palettes. My brain was fully smooth while working on this one, I swear. It was really nice coloring like, ooh, I want this to be dark purple and I want that to be hot pink, instead of agonizing through the rocket science that is creating a cohesive color scheme. You know, maybe I should redraw this sometime, with effort, and make it into a challenge. I'd say I gave this illustration about 20%. I wonder what 100% would look like. Probably worse. As much as I'm ragging on this, I do think it looks very good. Also, I never mentioned it before, but the pen she's holding is the gel pen that I love so much from the previous video, which you should check out next. I think my favorite parts of this illustration are the legging stripe, the head, and the puke emoji on the hoodie. Well, it's 10 p.m., My wife is painting at the desk behind me, and I'm ready to record some more voiceover. Once again, I started with the feed and figured out the rest from there. The sketching process didn't take very long, as I kept things pretty simple. I didn't put any real detail into the shoes again, which I regret, but I feel like the drawing would have turned out very differently if everything else stayed simple, but his boots were ultra detailed. I also don't know why I decided to line the sketch. Well, that's a lie. It's because I wanted to use the gel pen that I love so much. The sketch was very clean. There wasn't really a reason to line it, as I was going to take a picture and bring it to Final and Procreate anyway. But life's full of unexplainable things like that. Speaking of bringing things into Procreate, let's see if I can bring the iPad into frame in a single take. That wasn't too bad. Alright, let's get cracking on the line art. I love the function in Procreate that you see me doing here a lot, where I'll draw a line that's curved or trying to be straight or a circle, and then pause, and it corrects into a smooth version of what I drew. I'm positive this has a name, I just don't know it. It's hard to line nicely when your brush is so thin. It really picks up the minute wobbles in your hand. I wouldn't say I have particularly shaky hands, but something about Procreate really brings the wobbly lines out of me. People have suggested that I get paper textured screen covers for my iPad, but I've tried them before and I haven't really enjoyed the experience. Also, they cost like $30, which is way too much for a sticky sheet of plastic if you ask me. I know they also create nib covers for your Apple Pencil, which I assume would also add texture, but I feel like they'd fall off really easily and get lost. There's a world of iPad accessories out there, and I have explored almost none of them, with the exception of an attachable keyboard that Shelby had for their iPad that eventually broke from being bent. We wrote a lot of Neocosmos on it though. It lived a good long life. I've just about finished the line art here, and I hope you're prepared for me to use another one of Procreate's default palettes to color, because that's exactly what I'm gonna do. I did these two pieces in the same day and was really on that easy street coloring life. You know, if you've made it this far, I want to say thank you. And also, I want to say I'm sorry for how messy the background is. I just now realized there's a can of Diet Coke just sitting there in frame. Well, art is rarely the sterile experience many YouTubers show it to be. In time, I too will ditch the cluttered backgrounds for cleaner, more aesthetic framing. All in due time. I ended up shading this drawing because I felt it was lacking in visual intrigue. This kind of sets it apart from the first illustration, but they aren't necessarily meant to be a pair. It was fun doing the shading. I got to turn my brain off and just go for it. You know, when I was a younger artist, I discovered the joy of the multiply layer. I know there's lots of jokes about the dodge and burn tools, but really, for me, it was the multiply layer that I would abuse for easy shading. I would choose a blue or a purple, usually a flaming magenta, and scribble any and everywhere for the shading. Here's a good example of my crimes, actually. Maybe one day I'll do a video redrawing that piece. Let me know if you'd like to see that. Anyway, as time goes on, I started using the multiply layer a little more responsibly like I did here. And with that, we're done. I really enjoyed working on this piece. I like how the hair flips out from underneath the hood, and I like the tufts of fur in the ears, and the overall pose. Thanks for hanging out with me, and be sure to like, comment, and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one.